I'm Tammy Kolda, an applied mathematician, and this is Unlocking LaTeX Graphics. On this YouTube channel, I'm walking through the contents of my book of the same name, Unlocking LaTeX Graphics. This book is a concise guide to TikZ and PGF plots. If you like this channel, please subscribe, post questions, and share with your friends and colleagues. Today's topic is coordinate calculations. This means we'll cover how to do linear combinations of two coordinates or a linear interpolation of two coordinates. I'm assuming you're already a little bit familiar with TikZ. If not, go back and watch some of the previous videos linked in the show notes. As usual, we'll go ahead and do our project in Overleaf. So we'll start a new project, a blank project. I'll go ahead and name it Coordinate Calculations in TikZ LaTeX Graphics. And I'll go ahead and overwrite the beginning matter with what we need today. So let me go ahead and paste that. We'll shrink this side and make our layout a little bigger. So we have the package TikZ, which we always need. Today, it's really important. We're going to use a TikZ library called Calc, and we need that to do our coordinate calculations. We'll also use these packages, Parskip and Full Page, just to make things look nice. And Hyperref is so that I can link the author name to the YouTube channel in case you can't find it. So let's go ahead and get started. We'll first cover linear combinations. A linear combination of two points means that we can take any multiple of one point plus or minus any multiple of a second point. To demonstrate this, I'm going to set up with two arrows and two coordinates at their ends. So let me go ahead and paste that little segment of code and compile it. We draw these as arrows because these are vectors that we are taking linear combinations of. So this way you can think of it maybe in the right way. Of course, you won't always have arrows in your diagrams, but this gives you some idea of the way to think of it. We name each coordinate after its color so it's easy to remember. So at the point 1, 1 is the coordinate orange, and at the point 1, 0 is the coordinate cyan. We set the line style of everything in this drawing to be ultra thick. I cover line styles in a previous video linked below. So now let's take a linear combination of 2 times orange plus cyan, and we'll name that point purple, and we'll draw it in purple as we show here. So the syntax of this is that coordinate calculations go inside this special thing, which is open parenthesis dollar, and then it's ended with dollar close parenthesis. So those are your brackets for coordinate calculation. And then for a linear combination, you take your multiplier, an asterisk, and then the coordinate in parentheses. And then I could have a plus or minus in this second spot, and then an optional second multiplier scalar value, and then followed by an asterisk. The one trick you need to know here, or caveat, is that spaces matter. And there's one place where you're not allowed to have a space. As far as I can tell, everywhere else is okay, but you cannot have a space between the times and the open parenthesis for the coordinate. So if I compile it with that space there, I get a whole bunch of errors. So be very careful with that space. If you have a mystery compilation error, that might just be it. So just make sure you don't have a space there. If you have a space before the times, it's fine. Now, as you can see, this coordinate calculation did go where we expected it. We took 2 times the orange, which would take us to the point 2, 2, plus 1 times cyan, which takes us to the point 3, 2. Now let's make a combination of purple and subtract off 3 times the cyan, just so you can see how subtraction works. I'll draw that as an olive arrow. So let's go ahead and compile that. Where do you think that will go? Well, we started at the point 3, 2. We subtracted off 3 times 1, 0. And so we end up at the point 0, 2. Okay, so that works as you would expect it. And then finally, I'll show that you can have a minus multiplying the first coordinate. So you could take minus 1 times orange plus purple, and then that starts at the purple, and you minus 1 times orange, you end up at the point 2, 1. Now, I could have done purple minus orange. This would have been just as effective and a few less keystrokes, but I just wanted to show you that you could put the minus as a multiplier of the first coordinate. Next, we'll cover linear interpolation, meaning that we're looking at points along the line through 2 points. To demonstrate this, I'll get a little code segment compiled here that has 2 points that we can use. We put two coordinates named cyan and orange, and we mark these with circles colored according to the name, so it makes it easy to reference. We covered circles in a previous video linked in the show notes. Here I'm using a little extra trick where I'm defining the radius of all circles to be exactly 3 points by defining it in the options of the TikZ picture. Now let's first take a linear interpolation that is midway between cyan and orange. So I'll paste a little segment of code here and we'll go ahead and compile that. So the formatting is that we want to take open parenthesis dollar sign is the opening as before, and dollar sign close parenthesis is the closing. So again, we're doing a coordinate calculation. The format for linear interpolation is a point, then an exclamation point, then a scalar value, then an exclamation point, then the second coordinate. So here we use 0.5, that's exactly midway. We could make it a different value, here's 0.7. That means it's 70% of the way from cyan to orange, and we see that that looks like that's in the right place. We're not limited to do in between points. We can go past on either side. So if I were to draw another point, this time I'll draw a black point, using 1.3 as my parameter, that's like saying going 130% of the distance from cyan to orange, and so it goes 30% past the orange point to give the black point over here. And there's nothing that says you have to stay positive. You can put a negative value in here and go the opposite direction. So if I put a minus 0.5, here I'll draw an olive point, and I'll get a point here that's in the opposite direction. It's 50% of the way from cyan to orange, but then flipping to go the opposite direction. I hope you've enjoyed today's video. There's a link to the Overleaf document in the show notes. Please click like or subscribe if you want more videos like this. You can also buy the book, Unlocking LaTeX Graphics, at your favorite book retailer. And of course, I have a link in the show notes. Thanks for watching.